Thank you, Deputy Speaker. The ACDP is horrified that SASSA has had the audacity through the Minister to ask that the committee should not push it to reveal its contingency plans in public, as this might jeopardize the work done. And the ACDP is calling on the President of South Africa to address the nation in this hour of crisis and spell out what has been done and what will be done to meet the payment deadline and ensure there are no hitches. The situation placing the South African Social Security Agency at risk of not being able to pay the nation's social grants and pensions at the end of March has created general panic among the thousands of pensioners and grant recipients who fear they will not, that they will have nothing to live on come the end of the month. The ACDP notes that the president, before President Zuma left for Indonesia, he said he had spoken to Ministers Gordon and Dlamini and called on them to work together to find a solution to ensure the monies get paid. He also assured those entitled to grants that they will receive their money, urging the country to be calm on the matter. Now, this situation has now opened the President to further speculation that Minister Pravin Gordhan is being set up to take the blame. The ACDP recognizes that while the 17 million people who are dependent on social grants and most parties in this House do not share the President's confidence, we cannot accept defeat and we must all work together to avert this looming crisis. The operative word being, Honourable Minister, together. The ACDP finds it absurd that while government is trying to curb abuses of the social grant system and the original granting of the tender for payouts of the nation's social grants and pensions with Cashmaster Service Private Limited was itself found to be illegitimate by the Constitutional Court. As the court suspended the declaration of invalidity until SASSA issued the awarded a fresh tender, or until March 31st, 2017, whichever event occurred first, we are now down to the wire. In deciding SASSA could do the job, the three-year process has proved that government has bitten off more than it can chew, as SASSA is nowhere near ready to assume the critical function. SASSA, in deciding that retaining the services of CPS, although it would be the extension of an illegal contract, would be the best way to go, they approached the Constitutional Court to regularize their intended action. Suggestions that the department was pressured politically to maintain the contract with CPS have been denied, but the situation is curious to say the least. Now, I seldom agree with the DA, but the question as to why Minister Dlamini is so hell-bent on ensuring the CPS continue disturbing social grants leaves no option but to investigate the situation fully. Thank you.
Honourable Gallo.
Deputy Speaker,